It's another example that this government is blindly building motorways.
I call Denise Roche.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise to take the last call on this bill for the Greens. We will be opposing this bill because, as the House has heard from my colleague Julianne Genter, this bill is completely flawed. It's weighted towards roads, roads and more roads as the only transport option. It allows the government to borrow to fund infrastructure that may not stack up economically. It allows for public-private partnerships and road tolling, so it privatises more of the public purse. And worst of all, this bill once more strips decision-making away from Auckland. What is it about this government? Why do they hate Auckland so much? One of the first things this government did when they first came into power was to remove Auckland's regional fuel tax. It was being collected to invest in public transport, things like the electric trains, and an opportunity for Auckland to save up for the Central Rail Link that's been on the agenda for years. In the Auckland Council's submission to the Transport and Industrial Relations Committee, they specifically asked to retain the ability for Council to gather regional fuel taxes because, as they said in their submission, and I quote, "It's important to not preempt the outcome of Auckland's investigation and consultation process in relation to alternative transport funding mechanisms by removing one of these mechanisms. Auckland Council considers that the removal of regional fuel tax as a potential funding option could be inconsistent with consultation principles established in case law." This bill not only undermines the Council's ability to raise money for transport options, but it also says that whatever decisions the Council makes about the spending priorities they may have, they have to be consistent with the government policy statement. And as noted in the verbal submission from Auckland Council, this provision, what the government's trying to do here, cuts across Section 15 of the Local Government, Auckland Council, Act 2009, which states that the governing body of Auckland Council is responsible and democratically accountable for setting transport objectives in Auckland. For ratepayers in Auckland, they contribute about $400 million a year to Auckland Transport for transport infrastructure. And I remind the House that it's not just roads, it's actually public transport, walking, cycling options. And it's not just the roads that the Minister may have chosen for dodgy, uneconomic reasons. I spoke with the Chair of the Auckland Transport Board today, Councillor Mike Lee, who says this government has deliberately singled out Auckland in this piece of legislation and has at least been consistent in their approach to dismantling any type of democracy for the region. The supercity legislation was the first go they had. The legislation for the forced amalgamation also created the council-controlled organisation Auckland Transport, which is now, with this legislation, fast becoming a government-taking control organisation. And we have seen since then that the government has sought to undermine Auckland Council in every way, in the RMA changes, in the decision-making process around the unitary plan, and the changes to the Local Government Act, and more recently with the housing bill that will force Auckland into more urban spread when Aucklanders want a compact city. The Auckland Council submission points out the potential for conflicts when they say in their submission that the provisions relating to the Auckland Regional Land Transport Plan need to take into account the different governance arrangements in Auckland and the existence of the Auckland Spatial Plan, which was required of them by this government when they set up the super city. This government has interfered so much in Auckland that this government is fast becoming the worst nanny state government in history. We will not be voting for this bill. It cedes power to the government so that they can give more power to their vested interests. And the Sky City deal is a classic example of that. With this interference, there is less control for ordinary citizens over their environment and indeed over their lives. We won't be voting for it.
I call Speaker, Simon O'Connor.
I thought actually we were discussing the Land Transport Management Bill. I wasn't quite sure what was